the scores of household names. Well, occasionally you'll hear about the actual winners of an event. But to the endurance specialist, many times just finishing the race is a victory enough. Well, finishing is no small feat in the most grueling one-day events in the world of cycling. The 166-mile Paris-Roubaix Bike Classic. Those slightly bent personalities who attempt such a torture test find themselves with twisted bodies and bikes to match. You can see why they call this ordeal the Hell of the North. And in the thick of it was American Greg LeMond, who would go on to finish this race in historic fourth.
I didn't crash in front, so I had some luck, but we'll soon have enough to find out.
July, it was time for LeMond to set his sights on a more formidable challenge, the Tour de France, a Super Bowl of cycling that travels through the picturesque French countryside as millions of Europeans gather for a glimpse of their heroes. The Tour, the most prestigious event in the sport of cycling. Greg LeMond was hired this year to ride on Frenchman Bernard Hinault's team to help him win. For the French, the Tour is everything, and for 4 weeks through it all, the vignettes of drama played out in real life and to a television audience of millions.
Do you want me to punch you in the face?
A wounded Bernard Hinault after a horrible crash. LeMond's tears of anger. The constant overpowering attention for Hinault.
Your turn.
The blinding exhaustion. It's a battle that has already left its marks. Despite a broken nose and a concussion, Hinault kept the lead on his way to a fifth Tour win. Along the way, LeMond, though, became the first American ever to win a stage of the Tour de France. At one point, LeMond had a chance to race for himself, but remained loyal, if not reluctantly, to his mentor, Hinault. And as the final stage cruised into Paris, it would be the veteran Bernard Hinault donning his fifth Maillot Jaune, or yellow jersey, which in the future...